Hello, my beautiful love goods, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm finally doing a speed build. I know it's been forever. It's been forever and a day, but I decided to build a house that was really basic just because I was in the mood and I didn't really want to build something that was crazy, you know, elaborate or anything. And I thought I would just do a simple house that I could decorate that looked nice and functional. I don't know. I was in the mood and I didn't want to think too much. And this house actually is pretty much not directly taken, but it's pretty much the same as a house that I renovated in The Sims 3. I renovated it on my own time. I know, I actually played the game for myself for a change. But yeah, I just found a starter house in Hidden Springs and I just renovated it and I really liked how it looked. And so I basically just took the same exact idea that I was using in The Sims 3 and I moved it into The Sims 4. And I had a lot of fun and I thought I'd share it with you all. So here it is. It does contain some custom content. Most of the CC that I use is by Peacemaker, Felixander, Harry, Illogical Sims, and I'm trying to think, Max Sims, I think, and Novus, and Dream Team Sims. Okay, I'm gonna link them all in the description if I remember, okay? But yeah, if there's like a specific item that you see that you're like, ooh, what is that that I want? Please ask me. I don't mind whatsoever. I will try my best to answer because I usually know what I'm using in the build. I don't go crazy with CC and I try not to like literally just cram it full of CC. I try to mix it with EA content as well because that's what I like. But yeah, this house is actually, it's built in Brychester, of course, because Brychester is beautiful, and it has 20 by 15 lots, which are my favorite lots. But yeah, it's a really nice little house, very simple, very basic, and I just kind of imagined it was a starter house that, you know, a couple of roommates, they renovated, and they just kind of fixed it up a bit over time, and maybe they've been here for a bit, and they're both going to college, and they're like, maybe they're seniors in college and they're working through college and they just renovated. I don't know. It's whatever you think. But yeah, it's a pretty generic house for the most part. It doesn't have like a specific like, oh, it's for this type of sim. It can kind of be for anything. That's usually how I build for myself because I don't know what my sims are going to turn into whenever I play them. And I just like to have that, you know, open. I don't know. Like I like to be able to just kind of do whatever. But yeah, anyway, as you can see, I am actually using Peacemaker's windows and shutters there. They are from his, I want to say, it's not the Georgian set. I think it's the Austere building set or something like that. That's what the windows and the shutters are. The doors, I can't particularly say which. I believe they're from the Georgian set as well. Yeah, they're really nice. They're really, really nice windows. There's so many colors on those windows. They're so versatile. Like you can use them in modern builds, you can use them in traditional builds, and in this case it's kind of both because I kind of went with like a woodsy modern kind of vibe. I've been obsessing over this style lately, over this kind of color scheme and just aesthetic, I guess you could say, if I'm using that word correctly. I've just been really into like dark woods and like dark rich colored woods, like a lot of dark green, like really rich dark green, like a foresty green, and like with little pops of like a burnt orange. I don't know, I just like, I've been really into like this earthy kind of color palette lately, and that's just with everything, with like art and with, you know, building in The Sims and everything. I've just been really, really into that for some reason. I don't know if it's the time of year or if it's just me kind of fully embracing who I am as a person. But yeah, I've just been really into the color scheme. It's just been really nice. And Peacemaker's content really, really, really works with that really well too, because he has the perfect colors. This paneling here, it's just like a wall. It's not really paneling. It's part of a paneling set that he has, but it looks like just like painted walls essentially in this preset or in this version. English number one. Anyway, but yeah, his content just really, really works really well with the vibe that I'm trying to go for. So yeah, as you can see, copper sink, hello, yes, of course. I'm never gonna not use a copper sink. Did that make sense? I don't know, but you know what I mean. Like, I'm always going to try to use a copper sink if I can, if it makes sense, just because I kind of have an obsession with them. Like, I remember seeing a copper sink in a tiny house on like YouTube. Like, I saw a tiny house tour years ago, and it was like a hammered copper sink. It looked really rustic and really pretty. And ever since, I've just been obsessed. And I never really did it in The Sims, because when I built in The Sims before, I would always kind of just default to specific things for no reason, really, other than that I was just used to using them. But now I'm like trying to push myself to use different things and use different swatches and, you know, experiment and actually use the content that I have in my game, you know, CC and non-CC like. So yeah, but anyway, the kitchen's really cute. Really, really like the kitchen. That refrigerator, it's going to be very hard to find. I'm going to try my best to find a link to it. It took me a while to actually figure out where to re-download it, because I had deleted those files for some reason, and then I got sad and tried to find them, and I couldn't. But it's by Maxims? Maxims? MXims? I'm not really sure how to pronounce their username, but it's MXIMS, and they have some of the nicest CC, like, ever. It's a little bit on the alpha side, I know, but I kind of love it so much. Like, that desk there that I put the laptop on, that's from that creator, and the refrigerator is as well, and there's, like, a few other bits and bobs that I use, just, like, little bits of decor that I like by that creator, and yeah, but anyway, and the couch and the chair here, they are by Peacemaker, and they're just really, really nice. I do change the chair out for something different so that it's like more of like a mix and match vibe, but it's still a Peacemaker chair. I just love his style. Like, his style of CC isn't like ultra modern. It's more modern design, kind of inspired by like mid-century design, but still kind of contemporary. It's just like a really nice balance, and I really love using it, honestly. It's some of the nicest CC out there. Peacemaker is my favorite CC creator, if you couldn't tell, and I'm the biggest Peacemaker stan out there. Yes, I will say that. Somebody said that in the comments so long ago, and you know what, they ain't wrong, so you know. But yeah, the house is just pretty open plan here. I just kind of kept it simple. The house is pretty much the same design as the house that I built in The Sims, or renovated in The Sims 3. It was really fun playing The Sims 3 again. Can I just say that? I was just renovating this house, and I don't know, there's just something about the customization, whoa, I could not English there for a second, but the customization was so fun, and unfortunately, The Sims 3 is kind of clunky, so it doesn't run very well, but I am very, very excited for a game to come out, you know, sometime in the future. I'm not sure when, there's not a date set, but there's a game that, if y'all haven't heard of, it's called Paralives, and it's essentially kind of what The Sims wants to be. Just saying. But seriously, the building, it's basically a life simulation game with building in it. I know it sounds just like The Sims, but it kind of is, but I'm kind of excited because it's an indie game, and the customization that we've been able to see with building houses is incredible. Like, it takes it to a whole new level. I will say the aesthetic and like the style is a little bit, I don't want to say simpler, but it's just different from The Sims 4. Like, I feel like The Sims 4 has got a very specific set style, and Paralives is definitely different, but I'm very excited for it. Will I stop building in The Sims 4? Absolutely not. But will I be doing some builds in Paralives when that comes out? Absolutely. So be prepared for that. And I honestly, right here, this little section of the living room, I love it so much. You can see the light coming in from those windows onto the pillows there, and I made sure to put some yellow in there. This house, I don't know why, it's so simple, but I just love it so much. It's so cozy and so just perfect. I don't know why, I love it. It's just amazing. Definitely recommend just playing around in the older Sims games and looking at the house plans and like redoing them, because it's fun. I really like doing it. I'm definitely going to do it again. I'm probably going to go into The Sims 2 and find a house and then like draw it out or something, and then like redo it in The Sims 4 and like see if I can just do it better without really changing too much. But Yeah, and this is the bathroom. There's only one bathroom in this house, and it is downstairs. I just thought maybe it was an older house or something, and it was added onto, and they couldn't really build a bathroom upstairs and because it was too expensive. Or maybe they were planning on doing that in the future, but they never really did. Who knows? But I just wanted to kind of go with the floor plan that I had set, and I really like the little bathroom. It's really cute. It's simple and cozy, but it's, you know, essential, and it's got some plants in it. So, yeah. And that little table that I just put down, that is by Maxim's. I don't know how to say their username again, but you know who I'm talking about. It's perfect for putting little plants on in front of a window. I love that so much. And yes, you do see me thinking about putting a bathroom upstairs, but I was like, you know what? Two bathrooms for two bedrooms, that's crazy. I'm just gonna do two bedrooms upstairs and call it that. The two roommates that I had imagined living here, one of them I kind of imagined being a bit more artistic and a bit more focused on like a creative field. And then this bedroom here, the first one I'm working on, is more, I wanna say more generic, but I kind of imagined that they liked video games. So it doesn't really look it, but in my head, they liked video games, I guess. But I don't know, maybe they were just more bookish or what have you. It's very much more of a grown-up looking place, I will say that. It doesn't seem like a college house. It almost seems like some people that, maybe the roommates that live here, they're both working and going to college, but they're like older, and maybe they didn't want to live on the dorms, in the dorms. Maybe they didn't want to live in the dorms because they were a little bit older and they just wanted to live in a house together, and that's why. Maybe that's it. That's the storyline. There you go. I didn't just think of that. But yeah, it's a really nice little bedroom. I actually like this bedroom a lot. It's a bit different because the other bedroom is a little bit simpler and cleaner and a bit more, not minimalist, but it's a little bit less crazy. Like there's less patterns and it just seems a little bit more basic, but not in a like plain kind of way. It just seems like it's intentional. But this one's a little bit more, not messy, but a little bit busier. Like there's patterns on the walls, and then there's the blanket, and then the rugs. I really like it. It's really nice. It's really fun too. I think I do leave this wallpaper in. This is from the base game. We got this update in an update a long, long time ago, and I absolutely love it. It's so fun to use. I never really use it though, so I need to start using it again. It's a nice wallpaper, and it's base game, which is crazy, but it's nice. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, Picture Amoeba, or I don't quote me on that actually. I don't know. There's a CC creator that I follow that I believe did a full wallpaper of that, so there's not any wainscoting on it. It's just full wall. What am I saying? What is my English? I'm having some tea right now, and it has yet to kick in a bit. If y'all don't know, I've unfortunately had to quit coffee because of a number of reasons, just because it bothers my body, it gives me panic attacks, etc., etc. So I'm back to drinking tea again, and I'm very happy about that, to be honest. But I'm having some Earl Grey tea, and it's definitely giving me a bit of energy, but in a good way. But yeah, this is a bedroom that I started with the intention of making a little bit more woodsy as well. Nothing really spoke to me. Like, I was working on it right here, and I really kind of liked how it looked, but it almost looked really cold. Like, the blue and the stone, it just felt cold, and I didn't want it to be like that. So as I worked with it a bit more and experimented with this bed from Novus, by the way, it's amazing. It's one of my favorite beds. It's so pretty. It's very alpha, I know, but hear me out. It's cute and it works. But yeah, it's a little bit cold looking right now because of the stone on that wall, and I just felt like it was a little bit overkill with that. So I do warm it up by kind of putting in some lighter walls, because I imagine an artist or some kind of creative person working in this room a lot, because, you know, they just don't really have the space anywhere else in the house and they just work in here. And I thought it'd be nicer to have it be like this, because it just felt a little bit warmer, a little bit more welcoming, and still not too busy. And, you know, it wasn't distracting. You know, it's kind of a little bit more straightforward. That's what I'm trying to say. But yeah, really like it. That chair is by Harry here on YouTube. If y'all don't know Harry, Harry's an amazing builder and CC creator. And that's from the Kishin set. Love that chair. It's so cute. I love the pattern on it and just the texture and just the vibe. It's just, it's like chef's kiss. But anyway, it's a little bit more of a simpler bedroom though, because I do kind of put some, you know, clothes on a rack here and, you know, an easel and a computer. I love the workspace. It's just so nice. It's clean, but lived in, which I'm here for. So that's definitely a look that I can never ever achieve, because either my space looks clean and perfect or messy as hell. I'm not even lying, because I have to clean my desk every single day, and in 5 minutes, it's messy again. So yeah, but anyway, I am about to finish up the build here. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. This build is actually available on the gallery. If you want to search for my username, Lukey Dean, and the hashtag Lukey, you can find it there. And it does have CC, so be sure to enable custom content in the little check mark thing under the advanced section on the gallery. And yeah, do let me know what type of Sims that you see living here, because I kind of don't really know what type of Sims. I know what type of Sims in a way, but not, I don't really know their personalities. I just know that it's two Sims that I kind of want to be roommates for a long time, and then they like slowly fall in love, because I have a romantic problem. I'm not gonna lie, I read a lot of romance and it rubs off into everything. Art simulates life, life simulates art. I don't know what I'm saying, but anyway, be sure to let me know what you think of this build in the comments down below, and stay tuned, because I am going to be uploading a little bit more. I say a little bit more, hopefully, but anyway, that is pretty much it. Thank you all so, so very much for watching. Stay weird, and beware of the Narcles.